Hello everyone! This week I want to show you a little trick that will make your life easier in case you have missing covariate values in your data. Just as a recall, as we show in the feature of the week 89, if some values are missing in your data for a categorical covariate for just some individuals, you can have a dot in the data for these individuals and the dataset is accepted. So for categorical covariates, Monolix creates an additional category NA, and you can decide in the statistical model tab how to group this category with another category. For continuous covariates such as age, it is not possible to just have a dot for missing values. So you can, for example, decide here to assign a typical value, which would be the median of age for all other individuals, which is in this case 31. But you could also decide to assign the mean age, which is around 41. So, will this imputed value influence my covariate effects? I don't want to modify the data each time I test a hypothesis. So the trick here is to instead give a value that is out of range for the covariate, for example, a negative value, let's say minus 99. So this way, I keep the information that this value is missing in my dataset. Let me now show you how we can replace the minus 99 value by an imputed value directly in Monolix. I create a new project with the dataset with the missing covariate values. And in the covariate viewer, I can directly spot that some individuals are out of range for age. When I hover on a dot here, I can see that this is ID 16, ID 9, and ID 1. So these three IDs have a missing value for age. I can select one of these IDs, look at the data for the corresponding individual, and now I'm going to select a two-compartment model to model this data. I want to check what is the covariate effect of age on my parameters. Covariate effects can be added in the statistical model tab, down here. To replace the missing age values, I will create a new continuous covariate that corresponds to the age column, except that the minus 99 values will be replaced by a more meaningful imputed value. To do this, there is a formula. Let's see which formula we need to input here. What I want this formula to do is taking the age value from the dataset. And if age is missing, that is, if the value of age is negative in my dataset, I want to test a hypothesis to replace it with median age. I would like to test also what happens if I replace it with mean age instead, or with another imputed value for age. Using if-else statements is not possible in the formula box in Monolix, but here is a formula which encompasses the two cases with mean and max functions. This way, we define a transformed age, which will be our new continuous covariate. Let's see how the formula works for a given imputed value. So when the age value is missing, age is negative, so max of age and 0 is 0. And the mean of age and 0 is age, so the whole formula is equal to the imputed value. When the age value is available, age is positive, so the max of age and 0 is age, and the mean of age and 0 is 0. So the term on the right cancels out, and the transformed age is equal to age, which is what we want. So this is the formula I'm going to enter in the formula box to create my continuous covariates. I create a covariate for age for each of my hypotheses. So I will create transform age in case I use the median for missing values. I use my formula, and instead of the imputed value, I use the median 31. I will create another covariate, which is the transform age in case I use mean value for missing values. And in my formula, I will use 41 for the imputed value. Now, what happens if I add a covariate effect of my transformed age on the clearance? as my parameter CL is log normally distributed, I would like to have also a log transformation for age so that I end up with the typical power law relationship. Note that usually I can very quickly log transform a covariate by clicking on the covariate, add log transformed. For my transformed covariate that I have just created, this option is not available, but I can again use add continuous covariate and further transform the covariates that I created because they are now available for use in this formula box. Be careful that the statistics of TH here are impacted by the value that I imputed. So you should compute the typical value that you want to use outside of Monolix using only the remaining IDs. I will create the log transformed age in case I use median for missing values. And I type log of my covariate divided by 31. And I will do the same in case I use the mean for missing values. So log transform age mean for missing. Okay. And now I run my project and Monolix is going to check if there is a covariate effect of age on one of the parameters in all cases. I see in this case that whatever I use for missing values, the results of statistical tests suggest to add a covariate effect of age on the clearance. I can also look at the plots, individual parameters versus covariates, and here I can select the parameter clearance, and I can select the log transformed covariates that I created. Here you see that this ID 16 has different imputed values in the case of mean for missing values or median for missing values. But you see that in both cases, there is a clear correlation in between the log transformed clearance and the log transformed covariate age. So there doesn't seem to be an influence between the imputed value that I selected and the fact that there will be a covariate effect of age on my clearance parameter. As a next step, I would try different model using one or the other covariate to include the covariate effect of age on the clearance. And I would compare these models in Sycomore. Note that all this can be done without changing the dataset. I wrote the formula in the description below in case you want to use it, so that you just need to copy-paste it in the formula box. See you next week!